Good morning, students. Welcome to English class. In this module, we deal with snapshots prose 3, part 2 of Ranga's Marriage, written by Masti Vengatesha Iyengar. In the first part of the lesson, we discussed about the decision taken by Shyama, our narrator, to get Ranga married. Here, let's see how he works out his plan. Ranga sees and hears Ratna. Ratna was quite familiar with the narrator as he visited Ramarao's place frequently. The narrator thought of a plan to introduce Ratna to Ranga. He asked Ramarao to send Ratna to his place as he wanted to send some buttermilk for them. She came all dressed up. The narrator insisted upon her to sing a song while he sent someone to call Ranga. Just as she was singing, Ranga arrived at the door. Her melodious voice touched his ears, and thus he did not want to interrupt the singing. So he stood at the door. He was curious to see the singer and very cautiously tried to have a look. On seeing a stranger, Ratna immediately stopped singing. There was an awkward silence in the room. Curious about the girl, Ranga said that he feels it was his coming that stopped the singing, so he must leave. However, he did not. The narrator jokes about it and says one cannot expect actions and words to match. After a few minutes, Ranga asks the narrator about the girl. The narrator replies very cleverly and intends on seeing Ranga's interest in knowing about Ratna. Thus, he says who she is not of that much importance because he is already married and Ranga doesn't intend on marrying any time soon. Hearing the narrator's reply, Ranga got excited, although he did not show it, but was quite evident. Full of hope, he asks if she isn't married yet, to which the narrator replies that she is, probably a year ago. Ranga was disappointed and disheartened. A very disappointed Ranga. Our narrator, having stayed certain liking in the mind of Ranga for Ratna, went on to complete his play. He went to the village Shastri and told him everything that had to be said and done. Then he met Ranga that afternoon. He carried the same disappointment on his face. The narrator very wittily makes a remark that he went through the same feelings when he was seeing girls for himself. Furthermore, he suggested that they go see Shastri to see if the stars, that is Guru for Jupiter and Shani for Saturn, are in their favor. Ranga went with him. The guesses. Shastriji implied not having seen the narrator in a long while, which is obviously not true as they had met before the same morning. Here, the narrator reveals his pet name, Shyama, as they called him in the village. Shastri continued his role and acted surprised on seeing Ranga. Shastri took out his essentials, moved his lips while counting quickly, and asked Ranga about his star, which he did not know. Shastri appeared to be doing certain calculations. After a moment, he indicated that Ranga has a girl in his mind. Shastri replied that the girl is likely to have a name of something found in the ocean. Their guesses include Kamala, Pachi, Moss, Pearl, and then suddenly Shastri said Ratna. All of it came together now to a girl named Ratna, who is the niece of Ramarao. The Shastras. Ranga was both surprised and happy because Shastri's predictions were right. He immediately became disappointed when he recalled that Ratna was married. Both of them left and crossed Ramarao's door, where Shyama went to see Ratna for a minute and came back. When the narrator comes back, he announces that, fortunately, Ratna is not married and someone might have wrongly conveyed it to him about that. The narrator expresses his amazement at the fact that he has been thinking about Ratna and asks him to swear upon the truth. To his surprise, Renga told him the truth that whatever Shastri said is true. His belief in all the Shastras had strengthened. Shyama went to see Shastri that evening when he was near the well and remarked about how well he did what Shyama told him to. Shastri seemed to not like what the narrator was saying. Thus, he says that whatever he said could very clearly be seen in the Shastras. He completely disagreed with having staged the entire conversation. Rengappa invites the narrator. The narrator takes us a few years forward, where Renga and Ratna are happily married, had a 3-year-old son, and Ratna was 8 months pregnant. Renga's sister had come over to help them. It was Shyama's birthday. Yes, the couple named their son after the narrator, as it is a common foreign tradition to name your child after someone you truly admire. When the narrator went there for dinner, Shyama came running to him only to show his love by holding his leg. The narrator kissed him and gave him a ring. The narrator writes an ending note to all the readers, hoping that they were not bored. Dear students, hope you are clear with the influence of English, the language and the way of life on Indian life as reflected in the story, and astrologers' perceptions in conducting a marriage. Thank you. Have a nice day.